atrial flutter. On an ECG, the P waves lose their distinction due to the rapid atrial rate. The waves blend together in a sawtooth appearance and are called flutter waves, or capital F waves. These waves are the hallmark of atrial flutter. The AV node acts as a gatekeeper and protects the ventricles from the extremely fast atrial rates. It accepts more than 180 impulses per minute and allows every second, third, or fourth impulse to be conducted, the ratio of which determines the ventricular rate. One of the most common ventricular rates is 150 beats per minute. With an atrial rate of 300 beats per minute, the rhythm is referred to as a 2-to-1 block. If the conduction ratio remains constant, 2-to-1, the ventricular rhythm will be regular, and the rhythm is described as atrial flutter with 2-to-1 conduction. If the conduction rate varies from 4-to-1 to 2-to-1 to 5-to-1, the ventricular rhythm will be irregular, and the rhythm is described as atrial flutter with variable AV conduction. Okay. Now, so let's talk about the hallmark of atrial flutter. Big thing are the flutter waves. Okay, right in here. So in this one, you see in the capital F, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and that's pretty constant throughout. Okay, you have a normal QRS. The PRI is not measurable because they're not P waves, they're flutter waves. Okay. The ventricular rate, remember, may be slow, normal, or fast. Ours is, we're in a 4-to-1 conduction. The ventricular rate is 83 beats per minute. Remember, this is not a 6-second strip. And the atrial rate in this one is between 300 and 500 beats per minute. Okay. So, the atrial and ventricular rates are different, with obviously the atrial rate being much faster. You're going to see those flutter waves. Typically, they're in a ratio, a 2-to-1, a 3-to-1. Like I said, this one is a 4-to-1 conduction.